Hey, what's going on, guys? So perk rerolling is actually happening in just a couple days. The new perk reroll system is going to make use of a new in-game section or tab called the Perk Recombobulator. And unlike most popular theories out there, we will in fact be able to reroll each perk many times over. So for instance, if we wanted to change the level 5 perk on a weapon, it would not lock the level 10, 15, 20, and so forth perks. We will have the option of redoing every perk slot, and on top of that, each perk will have 5 tiers of rarity of value that we can upgrade through. So if you slap a rare in, you can upgrade it to epic, to legendary, and so forth. So we will have full control over our weapons and traps, by the way. Traps are going to be included. And if you don't like something that you did, like for instance, if you rolled damage and you wanted headshot damage, no worries, you can re-perk it. So it's cool. It's way cool. It sounds like a solid system. Now, with this new system, they had to put into place some perk rules for obvious reasons. You cannot run around 105% crit chance, you silly gooses. So analyzing all of the images and videos that Epic has released so far, I've come to the following conclusions in regards to the perk slot options. Epic has released multiple images showing different weapons, and the following has stayed true on all of them. Now, they might have gone as far as having some different rules or formats for different weapons, but I feel like that's pretty unlikely. I feel like these rules are going to follow suit for every weapon, but we will not know for sure. We will definitely know for sure in a couple days. Really quickly, though, before I get into how the perk slots will work, there are going to be new crafting materials used for the Recombobulator. Reperk appears to be used across the board for upgrading and for reperking. Whether you are changing, let's say, a damage perk for a headshot to damage, like I stated earlier, or if you are upgrading the rare quality of damage to an epic quality of damage, reperk is going to be used. The perk up is only going to be used when you are upgrading a perk. There are also going to be elemental materials used for selecting the elemental types of your weapons called Fire Up, Amp Up, and Frost Up. They have not shown or released what the energy one is going to be. Now, in regards to the options we will have for perks on the weapons, we will not be able to run all one perk in every slot. For instance, slot 1, the level 5 perk, is like a damage altering slot where we will be able to pick the following perks: Damage, Crit Rating, aka the new crit chance, Crit Damage, and or Fire Rate are going to be the options for slot 1. Slot 2, the level 10 perk, is a performance altering slot where we will be able to pick things like Durability, Magazine Size, Reload Speed, and or Weapon Stability. Perk slots 3 and 4 are both unlocked at level 15, and slot 3 appears to be the elemental slot. This is where we will be able to designate fire, water, nature, energy, and yes, physical. Now, before you all laugh at the option of physical, please notice that they have added a plus 32% damage to the physical damage perk. What this is actually going to do is allow the true min-maxers of the game a viable option in regards to fighting non-elemental husks. This also includes most mist monsters, guys. Takers, blasters, flingers. They don't have elemental forms, or at least not yet. So if you're trying to do damage, more damage to these types of monsters, physical is a better option for those that care. Next up is slot 4, and just as a reminder, it's also unlocked at level 15, just like the elemental slot. This is the second damage-altering perk slot and will allow us to pick headshot damage, crit rating, crit damage, and damage. I'm not quite 100% sure yet if fire rate is only available on the first perk and headshot is only available on the fourth perk, but as of everything that's been released so far, that is what it appears to be like. Also note that this weapon on screen is epic rarity, and it now has 5 perks instead of 4 perks. If we switch to a legendary weapon, we will now see that it has 6 perks instead of 5, so they're adding a perk to the different rarities. I've not gone into details for perk slot 5 or 6 yet, and I wanted to wait for this screen because this is really the only screen where we have seen anything regarding to these two slots. It seems to me that these two slots are going to be used for the situational perks like Affliction, Damage Dealt to Snared Targets, damage causes an AoE explosion, and so on. The screen does, however, show off a new perk that, combined with the physical bullet buff perk, could be devastating to mist monsters. This new perk is in slot 5 on screen, and it shows a rare quality 24% extra damage to mist monsters and bosses. So if you combine that with physical, you could potentially get more and more damage against the masturbators, the mouth breathers, and the other crap that really annoys you. Okay, so just as a recap, here's an image I created that shows off to the left-hand side the perk options per each perk slot. And I then created a spreadsheet showing off all of the confirmed perk values in black, and then the orange numbers in the legendary column are just my estimates on what they will be able to upgrade to. So if you want to play around with numbers early, this is a, I'm thinking, fairly accurate, pretty accurate set of numbers if you wanted to play around with it and look at it. These numbers are not confirmed, the orange ones, of course. However, I'm pretty positive these are going to be accurate, with the exception of the reload speed. That one seems to be a little high, unless they are in fact buffing the crap out of reload, which would make reload best in slot for the level 10 slot 2 perk. I don't care about stability so much or durability, but reload is huge. If you guys have been in my channel, that's my biggest complaint about playing some of the soldiers. So if we could get a massive buff to reload, that is that's insane. That'll be my go-to perk always. Anyway, the system is not out yet. I just had fun digging through all of the info that has been handed out thus far in hopes of figuring out the finer details of how this is going to work. And lo and behold, they actually released a ton of info just from the images in the video. So hopefully this fulfilled the itch for knowing the nitty-gritty on rerolls. I'm excited to start playing with these to make all kinds of situational weapons. If you guys are interested in max damage / DPS, I'll put out some videos similar to the video I made where I compared the assault weapon damage support bonus versus the assault weapon crit damage support bonus. So stay tuned for those. I'll definitely be putting out videos on how to optimize your weapons for different situations once this update goes live in a couple days as well. Couple more things. We will be able to evolve our epic schematics to legendaries, by the way. And it, just like our hero evolution, will cost 100 legendary flux to do so. So the evolution of schematics is going to be time-gated just like the evolution of heroes. They're going to share the same resource. Crit chances getting a rework, by the way. I figure I need to put this in here for those of you that are already aware and complaining. You will not be able to go above 25%-ish without getting hit by a diminishing curve / return. Epic posted an article regarding this. I'll have links down below to everything I've covered in this video for your viewing pleasure and if you want to go read the full details of this. But just as an FYI, before you get all panicky, the crit rate chance only applies to the weapon perks. Your hero perks and your squad bonuses are not getting affected by this crit rate nerf or rework, whatever you want to call it. More food for thought. Why would you even want to roll 2 crit rates anyways on your weapon perks when you could do like a crit rate and crit damage or a crit rate and a headshot? Remember, there's only 2 damage altering perk slots that share crit rate along with damage, crit damage, headshot, fire rate. So, yeah. So before you go bash your face into the keyboard over on that toxic website, just use your brain for a second, will you? Please? Anyways, you'll do what you do. Also, on that note, every weapon you've earned, collected, or hoarded thus far will be considered a legacy weapon and will not be affected by any of these changes. So if you have that god-rolled crit weapon, do not fear. Your weapon will remain the same. Now, in regards to using these said legacy weapons in the new Recombobulator, you will have to convert it into the new system. In doing so, the system will need to change your existing perks to match the new perk format on the weapons, and it will give you a preview of the changes, and in most cases, actually allow you to pick the new perks. We compared some of the static rolled weapons last night on stream to the new system, and for the most part, we will be able to make most of the event weapons stronger by converting them and putting them into the perk recombobulator. But only time will tell. The Gravedigger is one that's going to be, I'd have to actually sit down and run the numbers because it might be just from glancing at it, it might be better by itself, but we'll see. We'll see. Once this system is officially out, you can also expect more videos going over the static world weapons, like event weapons and such, on whether or not it's better to convert them into the system or leave them as a legacy weapon. Also, speaking of live streaming, I stream daily over on Twitch between the hours of 8 p.m. to 2 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So if you're up and alive and bored, feel free to swing by. Say hi, hang out, discuss things, laugh, point fingers, lurk, doesn't matter. Just get over there, get over there. It's a good time. We got a big, huge, growing community of people that like to play together, help each other out, talk, chit-chat, whatever. So, yeah, that's all I got for this one. I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye now.